we're going to go through and install a new theme for VirtualMin or Webmin, and we're going to install a new Webmin module. These are pretty easy things to do, and this won't be a long video. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to install Ilias Authentic theme, which is a really cool theme that he's recently been working on a lot. And so I've already opened up the web page for Authentic theme, which is just a GitHub page, and you can search for that, or you can just go to this URL up here, github.com/qoob/authentic-theme. And while there is the download zip file over here, we don't want to get that because that's not actually a Webmin theme package. A Webmin theme package is actually a gzip tarball, and Ilias provides a theme for that, or a module for that right down here. And so I'm going to right-click that, copy that link, and I'm going to go over here to VirtualMin, or actually this is, we're going to be doing this, this would work for Webmin as well. And so I click on the Webmin tab, I click on the Webmin category, go to Webmin configuration, and click on Webmin themes. And then there's an install theme tab here. And we can install a local from a local file, we can install from an uploaded file on something that we downloaded previously, or we can let Webmin download it for us. And as long as the source is trusted, there's no reason not to do that. So I'm gonna go ahead and punch in that address there. And I click install theme, and Webmin downloads it, and unzips it and installs it. And now I can return to the theme list, and it will show up in the list of available themes, and I can actually switch to it. And click change. Cool, there it is. Which, as you can see, this is a really nice looking theme with a lot of cool features. It tells you what's going on with new features that have been added since the last thing, which is something that VirtualMin also does. I'm going to close that, and I won't talk about all this because I did talk about this theme a little bit in the introduction to Webmin video. And now we're going to go ahead and install a module, which is almost identical. And you may notice that the interface looks a little different here. We don't have icons. We just have the little, just some text. But the same basic concept. Everything that was there before is here now. It just doesn't have icons anymore. And now we can do the same thing we did before. And it's actually kind of cool because you can search for modules from webmin.com. And so if we wanted to install something that was not, maybe had been deprecated and no longer included in the standard install, we could do that. Anything that Jamie's made, or anything that Jamie has adopted, it will show up over in this list. But I'm not going to install any of those. I'm going to install one from a website, and it's one that is a really useful module if you're helping out with translations for Webmin or VirtualMin or CloudMin. And it's pretty much the same deal. We just go and find the package, and hopefully it will take me to the right place. There we go. And I'm going to right click on that link and copy it and take it over here, and I paste that link in there and click install module. And now I downloaded it and installed it, and I've never looked at it in this theme before. We'll see how it looks. Good. And this actually makes some suggestions for additional modules that you might want to install, or that you probably need to install to use the application. And it's possible to install those with the CPAN module, or you may find that you can install them with the System Package Manager, which Webmin also provides. All right, that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.